السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على أشرف رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين، أما بعد، أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري وحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي، رب زدني علما، رب زدني علما، رب زدني علما. Honorable Chairman of this function, my dear brothers and sisters, all my dear scholars, on this golden opportunity, I would like to speak few words in front of you about Quran. I'm out with the topic, walking in the light of Quran. So let us go to Surah Fatiha, the starting point of Quran. Surah Fatiha. We all know Surah Fatiha by heart. And we know the meaning of Surah Fatiha, the turning point of the Quran. And Surah Fatiha has another name called Swalah. Why Allah gave another name called Swalah? What is the reason behind it? I'm going to mention it further, inshallah. When we go to prayer, we say Allahu Akbar. We start reading Surah Fatiha. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. When we read, Allah says, my worshipper had read Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. He is praising me. When we say Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, Allah says, he had glorified me. When we say Maliki Yawmiddin, Allah says, he had declared my greatness. When we say Iyyaka na'budu wa iyyaka nasta'in, when we say Iyyaka na'budu wa iyyaka nasta'in, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, this is between me and my worshipper, and whatever he asks now, I'm going to give him. So what we are asking for? Ihdina as-sirata al-mustaqim, a better way, a guide way, a good way. We are asking for a good way. That's a powerful dua which we can make ever. That's a reason why we are repeating that dua again and again in Salah. That's a reason why Surah Al-Fatiha had got a name called Salah. That's the reason behind it. Let us come to the point. Walking in the light of Quran. What is Quran? We know Quran is an Islamic book. It is an Islamic book and it's a solution for the Islamic brotherhoods. It's not just an Islamic book, it's too and a scientific book. It's a scientific solution for this world. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala itself says, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala declares that none can come up with a single verses that is similar to the Quran. That none can come up with a single verses that is similar to the beautiful Quran. None can come close to it. None can come close to it because it is amazing. The Quran is really amazing, absolutely amazing. None can come close to it. That is strictly perfect meaning, absolutely perfect, absolutely accurate meaning where Quran is talking about. That's the reason why science is trying to connect Quran. They can find more and more, they can discover more and more from Quran. They are seeing what had Quran revealed before 1500 years ago. They are searching how human is formed. The science is saying that human came from a monkey. Step by step, they have changed and the complete form of human came out. That's wrong, my dear brothers. Allah says in Quran, Allah says in Quran 32nd chapter, 7th verses, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alladhi ahsana kulla shay'in khalaqahu wa bada khalqal insani min teen. Allah who perfected everything which he had created and began the creation of human from teen, alak. Teen means clay. Allah took different parts of the earth and he molded the clay into water and he started preparing, he fashioned the clay into a human being. He fashioned the clay into a human structure and the clay started drying and the color started changing. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala named him Adam. Why? The word Adam is deriving from the word wudum. Wudum means wheat, because Adam alayhi salatu wasalam's body was colored like a wheat. So the Adam word came from the word Udum. Udum means wheat. The color of body of Adam alayhi salatu wasalam was similar to wheat. That's the reason behind it. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, 23rd chapter and 12th verses to 14th verses.
وَلَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ مِنْ سُلَالَةٍ مِنْ طِينٍ ثُمَّ جَعَلْنَاهُ نُطْفَةً فِي قَرَارٍ مَكِينٍ.
We created man from an extract of clay, then we made him as a drop. And we made him a drop of an alak, and then he changed into a mugda.
And Allah says in Quran, اقرأ باسم ربك الذي خلق خلق الإنسان من علق.
Allah had created insan min alak, by embryo. Allah created insan by embryo. Embryo is 28 days old baby, which is in mother's womb. Allah says in Quran, Allah had mentioned everything before 1500 years ago. Fundamental structure of unit of life is called cell. Group of cell combine and they make tissue. Group of tissue make organ. Group of organ make organic system. Group of organic system make organism. That's how every creature came to this world. By cell, every creature came to this world. And we human came, sperm plus ova converts to zygote, and zygote changes to embryo, and embryo into fetus. That's how human came. Allah had reported everything before 1500 years ago. But scientists are thinking, how did Prophet Muhammad come to know about this, all this scientific thing? There was no invention. There was no scientific technology. There was no scientific technology. There was nothing. How Prophet came to know about this? He was illiterated. How Prophet came to know about this? Allah taught him. Allah taught him by Quran. Quran is the only way which we can live today. Quran is the light of the world. May Allah bless us all. I pray, I conclude my words. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Assalamu alaikum.